Welcome to AI Toolbox. Today we're going to use Kaiber AI to create characters that we then bring to life with animation. Before we get started, you will need a Kaiber account. You can create a free account. For more information on how to get your account set up, just check the video description. I'll have a link. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe. It really helps me out. So first things first, if you're new to Kaiber, an easy way to get started is by going to the upper left of Super Studio, clicking Creative Templates, and then selecting the Character Animation Playground template. You will select that and then duplicate it, and it will put you on this workspace. What's great about this workspace is that Kaiber gives you all these different examples of what you can create, a variety of images and videos, all sorts of things. And you can scroll through their workspace. You can zoom in to specific modules and look and see what they did and how they created what they created. Kaiber imports a variety of different AI animation and art third-party modules. Runway video, Kling standard video, Flux image, Image Lab, Stable Diffusion. And the Super Studio is an infinite workspace where you can create lots of different art and animation, link them together, and have them in one canvas. We're going to get started. I'm just going to put my work down here at the bottom. The way you navigate around this space, by the way, is by using this little pad down here in the lower right corner. I don't love this way of navigating the space, but it does work. It's a little bit awkward. You have to get used to it. So what I did was I used Canva to create these stencils. And these are just elements that I downloaded from Canva. You could draw these on your own if you wanted to. Next, I went up to the flow menu and I selected Image Lab. Click that. Image Lab appears right here. And you upload your stencil into the Image Lab. This was created by just simply uploading the image, and I didn't have anything in my subject prompt. The subject prompt here is how you dictate what the final image should look like. So this was the first one, and this is just uploading the stencil. This one was uploading it, and then in the subject prompt, I put curious creature standing on a black background, and it created this. I don't know why he became fuzzy, but that's what they did. My next image, I just entered New York City into the subject prompt, and it created this. This is very interesting. I do like it. It's so weird, but it took very little prompting to create kind of like this urban dystopia. So next, in order to create the version that I'm using right now, I simply input Mars into the subject prompt. So I upload the different stencils, and in subject prompt, I just write Mars, click this happy face button. Every time you generate an image or a video in Kaiber, you are charged a certain amount of credits. This costs one credit. And click that happy face, and then it will generate an image. So here's my new image. It's just a little bit different than the other two, but we'll just go with it. And you can keep everything in one place by hovering over an image and clicking this Create Collection from Selection, and it'll group, you know, images into one batch. So next, now that I have a different version of the face man, I'm going to create one more version of this character. I'm going to remove this image and upload my last stencil. And then just leave everything the same and click the happy face. And then here's another version. This one looks even more different. I think his expression is influencing the overall background and texture of the image. Now let's bring these creatures to life. The first one that I've already created, what I did was I went up to the flow menu, go to video flows, and right now I'm using Runway video. You just click that and it'll appear on your canvas. So this is the one Runway video dialog box that pops up. You can just drag the image that you want to animate over here from your collections on the sidebar and instruct it on what you want it to do. So in this one, I say weightless spaceman jumping up and down on Mars. And you can also give it an ending keyframe if you know how you want this animation to end and just want Kaiber to kind of animate from point A to point B. I didn't do that. And you also can change like the aspect ratio of the video And you can make either a 5-second video or a 10-second video. It costs 25 credits to animate this video using Runway. And so you just click the happy face and then it will generate your video. And this is what it created for me. It's interesting because it's like he is weightless and he's not able to run backwards and forwards, I guess, just sideways on Mars. Now let's do another one. I'm going to go back over here to the Runway video, delete this, and add another creature and leave everything the same and just click this happy face button. And now my next video is done. So I just scroll over here, take a look at it. And this is him kind of jumping up and down. Next, let's try another stencil. I'm going to use the one where he's like running. And so this one, spaceman running on Mars. Keep it simple. And then once again, click the happy face. So now this is how it looks if he's running. So in this version of Spaceman, these are the different actions that he's doing so far. I really like these first two. I like the textures of them, the photorealism. This one's kind of interesting. He's actually moving forward rather than sideways. This one's my least favorite. I mean, it's just a very different style than the others, so you wouldn't necessarily have it in the same animation. Could. So now let's go back to one of the other ones, the one where the spaceman is in New York City. So I want to animate this one. So I'm going to go back to Runway Video, just delete the previous stencil, and go through and find that image that I created, which is right here. Bring it over. So let's say creature jumping up and down in New York City. And so we'll leave everything the same. Click the happy face. So now the animation is complete. And this is the creature. It's interesting how they're adding this entire environment, you know, with the crosswalk and the people, just by me, you know, specifying New York City. So anyway, this is the first step in character animation. If you remember, we started with this very simplistic stencil from Canva, and then we end up with animations that look like this. So I will be back with another tutorial on how you refine these and get more sophisticated results. But thanks for watching. Please, once again, like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. I'll be back soon with more videos.